Point to me?
Yes.
Mr. Wyckoff? Bryson, come in. Hey, Mr. Tita, how are you, sir? Good to see you. Good. Come on in. Yeah, it's tight.
Thank you.
Come to your left. Your right. You okay?
way faster than outside. Right. You try to use the atmosphere to range as much as possible, so you're kind of going like this. So this is, if the floor is so steep, it's going like this.
Yeah.
It's literally trying to use its entire body as a brake. And then it's using these flaps to just control this position. Mm-hmm. You try to achieve roughly a 70-degree angle. Somebody else?
Okay.
And then when it goes subside,
is that controlled by computer or by hand?
Like it's entirely and when it goes subside, it actually starts going. It's pulling down like this. So it's just, it's like a skydive. So it's just, you can think of these flaps like the skydiver's arms and legs. So it's pulling down like this. And then right at the end, it turns around and left.
How high is it?
Extremely high. So if you see, you see that first black cloud?
Yes.
We're looking at the leeward side of the rocket. So the other side, the windward side, has those black clouds. So we're looking at the leeward side.
Going out, pushing
out. Fault side.
Thank you.
Starship's fifth flight test is one of our most ambitious yet, and as we work to demonstrate techniques fundamental to Starship.
Thank you. Thank you. try not to do the same thing.
You want them up near the picnic table.
About 2.5 minutes. Do that a little bit longer. We see how Florence. That would be the altitude. 1 minute, 26. It's never guaranteed. Just once. We'll see if you can do it again. You can do it. The booster and the tower are looking really good.
Second attempt to catch the super heavy booster at the launch tower, as well as inside
In its gooseback fern, this gooseback fern. This gooseback fern lasts just a little bit over a minute, so we've got a little, approximately 30 seconds left.
Around the world.
A lot of small improvements. There's a big version of increase with the That'll be flying next year. That's got the version 3 of our engines. That'll look very different. That will be longer and have a lot more thrust and have the next generation engines. But you can see on those screens up there, that's the ship that is now going around the Earth. So if you want to maybe get a better view, if you come.
It has been a very exciting afternoon so far. We'd like to send it back over to Dan, who can give us that live view experience. Dan, once again, are you okay after witnessing another Starship launch?
Yeah, totally fine.
This is going around the Earth. It's going at 26,000 miles an hour. Kilometers an hour, I would say. About 16,000, 17,000 miles an hour.
Really cool to see him about 33 or 33. It's going to land in 30 minutes. Initially, we were good. And then we tripped a connect car
to about 600 miles from the coast of Australia.
So we went and did that water landing.
So it's actually going through the dark side of, like, Earth. Is, the region of Earth that it's going through is now dark. It'll enter the region of where northwest where it's actually sunny. So it's currently sunny, about 600 miles northwest of Australia. So it'll go out of Earth's shadow, and we should be able to see it land. And that'll be pretty cool.
So it's on its way. We're
landing in the bar. It's going to land in the water.
Okay. We're going to land one of those Raptor engines, the sea level ones in the middle.
Watching it re-enter is pretty wild because this thing flows really like super hot. I mean, it looks like special effects because it's like every color. It's like purple, red, white. It's wild. You can see the blast go real fast. There's some chance it will blow. If it doesn't blow up, it'll
blow.
It's still going to be pretty close to it.
Are you going to cover the ships, or is it lost?
If it doesn't blow up, we do have ships to try to bring it back, and then we can inspect it and learn more.
But this one won't be reused.
This one will not be reused. So this one is all about just learning. So it's about learning more. So we're going to actually, this time, we're going to enter at a steeper angle than before, so it's going to be a higher heating. And, we'll see if some of the changes we've made to the heat shield are better.
The last launch,
you can actually see where it was getting really hot because we moved some heat shields, so it was like kind of glowing and little bits were melting off and that kind of thing. So hopefully this time the heat shield should be more robust. We also reduced the amount of heat shielding, so there's about 6 feet less heat shielding on the sides, because we don't think that's necessary.
We are going to continue, though. The mission is not done. Exactly. The mission's not over.
We actually mechanically attached the
He's so cute.
Oh, thank you. Can you say hi?
Hi.
Jacket and sweater, but I guess. Well, before.
Yeah, on a flight day, you gotta wear a jacket.
Elon told the president that they're going over to the factory to do a tour, and then he wants to bring him back here.
Okay. We'll
Did you know that?
Okay. I just heard him say
okay.
We'll stay here. Just
you heard that too, yeah. Okay.
Well, I heard him say they were going. I didn't know if they were
and then
back.
He'd come back here for some other landing thing.
Great.
Okay.
Whatever they want to do. We're going to stay here. Update your... They're going to go to... There's too much sensitivity with the national security stuff. Wait, do you want to go to the departure where Christina can ask questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Are we doing that now, though, or when they come back from the back?
You can ask questions if you'd like. I don't know. Here?
Yeah, where they're standing.
Okay, once he begins photos, we will head up to the top for departure. So, Katrina, if you want to ask questions, you can come stand right here.
Right here.
Nope, it's up there where they're already lined up.
Oh, the sun is harsh today. Okay, so.
Questions?
I mean, it's up to you. Yeah. It's up to you.
Mr. President, are you reconsidering the nomination of Matt Gaetz?
No.
How far are you willing to go to get him confirmed?
I'm going to hold you guys right here. And Brandon, we're gonna